Hey, this is Nikki from My Healthy Beginning, and today we're here with Dr. Emily Hall. I've never referred to you as Dr. Emily Hall before. This is very exciting. Emily and I have been working together for a couple of years. I think it's about that long. She and her whole gaggle of children are on board for nutrition response testing here at My Healthy Beginning. And inside of the last year and a half, so many people are jumping in and taking advantage of virtual health and remote telehealth opportunities. And you guys have done a little bit of both. You were in-house, and then I know you were finishing school and probably stress and responsibilities ramping up like crazy. And there are times where you take advantage of the virtual health option over the in-person. So I would love for you to speak to, you know, A, what nutrition response testing does for you and your family, and B, what does the virtual aspect of that provide you with?
Sure. So in general, nutrition response testing honestly gave us our sanity back. Let's be perfectly honest. A six-person family, including my husband and I, there wasn't a lot of sanity to be had, especially with me going through school as well. But I had two babies in the middle of school because that's the smart way of doing things.
Exactly.
And my health completely bottomed out with that first pregnancy, and then especially with the traumatic birth that it was. And I almost died. So I didn't have a lot of brain left after losing as much blood as I did. It really took a toll on my brain and my heart, and couldn't see straight. And I just happened to see you at a lunch and learn, of course, right, of all things.
Oh, so funny. Yeah,
I came to talk at school, and it's like the world just came to me with what I needed to do. And you found literally everything that any blood test had ever found in about a half hour.
I do remember thinking, why is your baby so orange?
Well, I loved it when you were like, so, tell me what's up with, Jackson here, and, you know, give me a little history. I was like, look at him, just look at him. And you're like, I didn't want to say, like, no, he's orange.
He is orange.
Yeah.
You're no longer an orange little dude. That's exciting. No.
We do know when his program is a little off, he does start to turn a little orange.
Isn't that interesting?
One of his tells. So it's cool that he has a tell. Mm-hmm. But
we all have them, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, you just need to learn to pay attention to it. And his is just so darn obvious.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I mean, he and Gracie, Gracie's extremely hyperactive, and we found out that that was parasites where nobody else could figure that out either. And within a month, they started showing great signs of progress. And I took about 4 months to start showing any real progress. I mean, my body was doing the work, obviously, but there was a lot to work through. And that's what nutrition response did for us. It literally gave me back my brain. I went from a B student, AB student, to almost failing back to an AB student. So yeah, it got me through school. So maybe you should share my doctorate.
You're right. Maybe so. Now, from the virtual standpoint, the pull for you, is it convenience? Is it time? Is it, because sometimes you're here in office and sometimes we get like the SOS, like we can't make it in and we have this going on, and, you know, put us on the calendar wherever you can find us.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Convenience is huge. I mean, we're an hour away from you, so we absolutely do not mind making that trek. It's great to be in office and have the whole experience and all. When we can, but especially this last trimester where your hours and my hours for my internship were exactly the same, there was just no getting in. So, I mean, the next best thing was Thursdays. All right, put us in and do a virtual. And I was a little leery at first. I'm not going to lie. You don't learn a lot about energy in school as much as you'd think you would. Especially for a natural health perspective for everything. So that was kind of interesting hearing it for the first time from you that, hey, this is actually a doable thing. And I'm like, wait, what? Like, are you talking possession? Like, what are you talking? You know, just like, what the heck?
Right.
Right. I was really leery, and you explained it really well. And then I heard it from a couple other people after it, and I was like, oh, okay. It seems to be a real thing. And I started doing some research on it, and I was like, oh no, I get it. Okay. Mm-hmm. So it started with not a convenience, but it turned out to be really interesting, especially the insight that you can give for my children. Like, I can't get into their heads or their bodies myself, but I can see as a mother that I'm like, oh, I think Gracie is really struggling with a few things internally that I just can't quite get a feel on. And it's like, when you go with the virtual, you can get a lot better feel than ever I can. And that insight has been absolutely priceless. Mm-hmm. It was really cool. So I'm like, mm-hmm. I don't know. I don't even know if I want her to come in to office anymore with her squirreliness. You go faster just with the proxy, and mm-hmm. it's great.
I have to say too, that there is something to be said about that. Like, there's information that lands, you know, when we're in the room and we're doing our steps, we're running through the process on the table. But if I ignore this incoming information, you know, it's like, that doesn't work to ignore that. There's information coming for a reason. I've had, you know, like, check the black socks. I don't know why, but okay, we'll check the black mm-hmm. socks. Why mm-hmm. are they a problem? Who knows? Texture, fabric, color, whatever. Let me just give that as an example. But what I love is there are times even when, for whatever reason, you're not on the phone with me when I'm doing the visits, and you'll give me some info prior, like, we're dealing with this or struggling with this or whatever. And then my favorite is when I, you know, toss it back to you on Facebook Messenger or something, and then you're like, oh my gosh, you nailed that. That's always really fun, because it nothing lands virtually for me like that's the thing, but there's just no disturbance. There's just nothing other than that connection and that being that related in the moment. I do love that. I really do love the ability to sort of see, if you will, what we sometimes can't when they're in the room. So I love that as well.
Like mold in my house.
Yes.
What? Yes. Go looking for it.
Found it.
Right. Thanks.
You're welcome. Sorry. Tell your husband I'm sorry for that expense. No. Right? I didn't mean to, Shane. Super sorry. But you spoke to the effectiveness, like, in particular with Gracie, mm-hmm. who is high energy, and she's, we can get her tested. It's doable, but she wants to test it. She wants to kind of push every button again. Love that. Yeah. She's got this fantastic personality. Doesn't mean that we can't test her in the moment. And for her, she's like a great virtual candidate, really. There's, you know, no one candidate over the other. It's fine. But that is a question that people will ask, is like, well, what is the effectiveness? Is in-person more effective than virtual or remote? We just got great results with it. So we have from the beginning. So some of it, I think, is what is the intent of the practitioner? What are the questions that we're asking? You know, and really, what is the client looking for? So being able to sort of start that session with, like, what is important? What is the need? You know, what is it that they are looking for today? And then being able to meet that need is, there are times where sometimes we get on a virtual visit, we're not even doing muscle testing. We're like, mom's in breakdown, and suddenly we're just having a conversation that gets mom empowered and gets her calm and gets her grounded. And she's got a couple more resources. And then she's like, oh, we didn't even test my kid. All right, I'm good. This is good. But mm-hmm. if you get mom in a really great place, then that kid's going to have a better week by way of whatever mom's dealing with, you know? So I love that opportunity that it does provide us. We've had moms who are like, I am in the car. Is that okay that I'm in the car when we're testing mom or one of the kids? You know, that doesn't, that really doesn't matter. One question that people ask about, I'll just say natural healthcare in general, is like, oh, it's just so expensive. What is your thought on that?
You should be asking why the rest of life is so cheap.
Huh. So great.
You get what you pay for, and
so great.
The good stuff is not cheap because it's so labor intensive. I mean, if you're going for organic food, for example, an organic farm is going to do a lot more crop rotation than a regular farm will. A standard farm does about 3 crops per entire farm. A really great, like, standard process that does organic farming will do 7 in order to not totally take all of the nutrients out of that soil. They're going to put different fertilizers, different types of fertilizers. It's not going to be here's the fertilizer that everybody does and it replenishes 3 out of 30 nutrients back into that soil. It's going to do all 30. Well, that's a lot of work. That's a lot of time, energy, money that they put into this process in order to get you the highest quality everything. So yeah, you get what you pay for. Mm-hmm. I mean, do you want to get a little black dress at Walmart or do you want to get it at Macy's? I'm sorry. I like to look good on my dates.
Sure. Sure.
The husband for the record.
There you go. I know. I can imagine that. That is an interesting thing. You know, I would say we tend to attract people who are ready to invest in their health. Like it is an investment. Our health is an investment. If we don't have health, we don't have anything in my opinion. So my favorite is kind of getting people to a place where they have 75% improvement. That's what I call maintenance in my world. And that might mean a smaller supplement program. That might mean, definitely means that their food knowledge went from here to here and maybe they land here. Right. But yeah. It's a far cry from where they were and gives them a bigger, better handle on their life. And my goal is to never have mom be a sous chef. So we're always looking to, if mom has one or more child on a program and, you know, one child has more issues than the other in terms of food, I always gear mom towards go where the bigger issues are, start small and take those baby steps and have that amazing ripple effect on your family because your husband mm-hmm. reaps all the benefit of the world.
Yeah.
And having the four of you managed with your health by nutrition response testing, healing from the inside out, finding things sometimes before they become a problem truly, is so beneficial. So I always tell people, like, it is a matter of, do you want doctor bills or do you want a choice in where you're spending your money upfront for your health, for things that have you feel good, that keep you running like the Energizer Bunny, or, you know, keep your sleeping well, keep your energy really high. So it's a bit of a mindset shift for sure.
Absolutely. And that's the funny thing too, is like when you look side to side, because my husband was late to the game getting in on nutrition response testing for himself, which he gets over by his work. So it's just super comfort. Mm-hmm. He just pop in or whatever, but, which you knew, of course. Mm-hmm. But when we started and we got on this plan and it was okay, Gracie is by far the most demanding as far as nutrition goes, food wise. So it's gluten-free, dairy-free, sugar-free, everything. Like you don't do any kind of sugar, any kind of, fake sugar, any, like, no, you have to avoid with her, so many things. And I was like, well, I'm not making 6 different meals. Like that's ridiculous. So yeah. We're all eating the same thing. I'm the one that's going to the grocery store to get the right foods. I'm the one that's going to be cooking. I'm the, you know, all of this stuff, and that's fine. But my husband, of course, started eating that way too. And while he would cheat here and there at lunch, right? For the most part, his diet went from like here to here.
Sure.
And all of a sudden, like when he started cheating, he's like, oh, that stuff just wrecked me. And I was like, I know. Are you ready to be done? No, it's fine. I got this. I can do this and give it 6 more months. And he's like, it's not even worth it. I'm not going back to gluten. Like that. Oh my gosh. I didn't even know that was a thing for me. And I was like, well, yeah, your body was desensitized to it. And like, he's like, all right, I'm ready to do this. And that's when he got on board too. But we had to play to Gracie's issues first in order for all of us to really take that full leap.
Mm-hmm. So that is an interesting thing for you to say too, that it was her in terms of food. So most families who come through the door, these moms are either coming for themselves. It's kind of like 50-50. They're coming because of themselves or they have a child. Mm-hmm. And so they either get on board by way of the child does a program. We don't require a parent needing to be on a program with a child on a program. We actually used to play that way and don't anymore for several reasons, but it's interesting the inspiration a child on a program will bring to a household, because mom starts to make the connection between like, well, wait, so I'm doing the shopping. Her needs are this. Like, if I don't understand those needs, if I don't understand those chemicals that need to be avoided, I can't do shopping in like an enlightened, empowered, educated way. So there's this gap, and most moms want to step into that gap, be the partner, not just the advocate for their child, but be the partner for their child in understanding and learning more. And then all of a sudden you've got two people getting well, and then you have two more people getting well, and then you have all six people in your house and your mom, like everybody is on a program and succeeding and doing really well in a way that works for them. So kudos to you for seeing really what works. And it's also fascinating to see kind of that beginning intensity of getting up and on top of a program with more frequent visits. The virtual aspect really allows for that so much convenience.
Yeah.
When we have someone who's within driving distance, I always ask them how far. Some are like, oh, it's no big deal to drive into the Twin Cities. And some like don't want to drive 35 minutes. So they come kind of knowing who we are. They come with questions around like, are you going to need me there every week? So a lot of times we'll modify a program. If they can come in once a month in person, we can handle every other visit remotely. So they get the experience of being in the office, you know, they get the heart scans. And that's a really fun way of doing it too. So I do love that very individualized approach, which is one of the million reasons why we choose to do something like nutrition response testing. Muscle testing gives us so much flexibility, gives us so much information, and really gives us access to kind of the unseen. And if we want to go ahead and back that up by the science with any sort of lab work, we can go ahead and do that. So it's really exciting kind of day and age to be practitioners doing what we're doing. I love that. I love that I can refer to you as Dr. Emily Hall. This is so fun. Yay, you. It's nice to hear it. Do say it again. Right. So lovely.
5 years of craziness.
Yeah, fine. Just a few years. Any other little nugget or tidbit? Like probably what's the biggest thing that you got? You said sanity was the thing that saved you. Yeah, at first. Where do you see this taking you in your future? Because your ages of your kiddos are what?
We've got 12, 7, 3, and 8 months.
Yeah, so little.
Mm-hmm.
A nice little gap there. Yeah,
it is. Yeah. It's interesting. Cause my oldest child of course has a little bit more of the unhealthy life behind him. So it's taking him a little bit more time to unwind, but sure. You can literally see child to child, younger, where it's taking hold, like what's quality versus quantity versus everything. And you've got Gracie going around the grocery store, telling little old ladies for real, the dangers and the evils of sugar. She has a whole soapbox,
funny
little speech that she literally gives just about everybody. Jackson looks at something, he goes, and we're like, no, not that one. It's gluten. And he's like, no, I can't have that. And then he'll tell people. And I mean, even from the even perspective of being pregnant while on this program, that was just beyond amazing. Like three pregnancies and laborious deliveries where it ran the gamut from just fine to the worst thing ever. And then having a pregnancy labor delivery while I was on a program, night and day difference. Oh my gosh. So many things you're like, oh, it's just pregnancy. It's just nutritional deficiencies actually. Yeah. And you can have a very comfortable pregnancy.
Yes.
Despite what you think you're going to feel. And it was just like, I mean, not to get a little too personal, but I mean, having Tucker and my midwives looking at his cord as he comes out, and they're like, normally they're like this, right? I don't know if you can see that, like whatever, like that. Yeah. His was like this. He had so much nutrition and building blocks going into him that we could really like, everything was the way it was really supposed to be. They looked at his placenta and they're like, that is the prettiest placenta we've ever seen. Literally, can we take a picture? And I was like, do it. I mean, if you can show that to women everywhere that, hey, this is achievable.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like a superhuman thing that happened. Like I'm just this amazing, like it's just my body. I'm great. I got this. I was like, no, it was a lot of work to get that. Nichi and I worked very hard on that. Right. Plus, thank you very much.
We did. Day by day, we grew that baby. Yes, we did.
I mean, night and day. So it's just cool to be able to see it earlier and earlier, getting the proper nutrition and everything that they need. And now so excited for Tucker or for any other children that may come our way, that they have such a better outlook on life from the jump.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'll be very interested to see how their health plays out in comparison to really the rest of my kids or from society in a general.
Well, I've got to say, literally the biggest compliment in all of this is that you became a nutrition response practitioner.
Yes.
I'm still like, oh my gosh, that's so amazing.
You can't unsee it.
No, you cannot. It's so exciting to see that.
I mean, as a chiropractor, adjusting is, it's awesome. I love it. I mean, I live for the snap, crackle, and pop, let me be honest, but mm-hmm. I mean, there's so many limitations to each aspect of the things that we do, and that this encompasses far more than just what I can snap, crackle, and pop out of people, right?
Mm-hmm.
I need to snap, crackle, pop, but then I need the nutrition to back it up, because that subluxation is going to come back if you don't have mm-hmm. the right building blocks to support it. So mm-hmm. there's that. And then, I mean, pulling into the emotional side of things, I mean, there's just so many aspects, and you can do so much with muscle testing. It's wicked awesome.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to leave it at that, because that is like absolutely perfect. If you are looking to optimize your health, you can find us at myhealthybeginning.com or give us a call at 612-418-3801. And Dr. Emily Hall, thank you so much for joining us. Appreciate you being on. You're welcome.
Yes. All right.